Hey guys, welcome to another Figma tutorial. Finally, the most exciting Figma update is here. By end of this tutorial, you will be able to create interactive prototypes for mobile and web in no time. I have covered the basics and 15 most common examples here. Here's a glimpse of what is covered. They are not at all difficult to learn if you pass these two main requirements. First, you must be approved beta tester for interactive components. You can sign up for that from the link below. The second requirement is to know how to use variants and prototyping. Link to both tutorials is in the description or somewhere here in the top. If you pass both of these requirements, let's dive into it. It will be great if you can follow along. Download the practice file from the links in the description or comment section. Now let's begin with mobile interactions. Here are our checkbox components. Interactive component update added a brand new action called Change To. We cannot select that just yet. We need to combine them as variants first. Let's create variants for checkbox, radio, and toggle. Once variants are created, we can now add interaction. Open Prototype tab. Select empty checkbox and connect the node to selected checkbox. Interactive component is now created. You can identify it by a brand new action called Change To. We can change animation, easing, and duration. Connect selected checkbox to unselected one to finish the interaction. I will follow the same process for radio and toggle. To try it out, you need to add instance of interactive component. Go to example playground page. Drag and drop checkbox, radio, and toggle from the assets panel. Preview prototype. These interactions open a lot of possibilities. Let's try more complex components. Connect to-do list item in the same way. Here we have two states, selected and non-selected. Add instance of it on the playground file to test it out. I'm not able to find it. Here's why we need to rename components and layers properly. We can add more items on the page to test it out. If you rename any of these text layers in one state, Figma will retain those in other states automatically. Preview prototype. As we created combined components, not checkbox but entire row is now clickable. As you can see, Figma is retaining the text overrides. Great job, Figma! Now, the next example is navigation drawer. As you already know, we need matching layers for Smart Animate to work. Thus, I am hiding this navigation links by moving it outside the frame. Connect the menu icon to expanded drawer. Connect cross icon back to the main frame. Menu and cross icons are using the same layers, hence they will animate. It is already added on the playground file. You can verify variant interactions by clicking on the trigger. Preview prototype. Oops, we need to move it to the front. Preview it again. Looks amazing. I can do this all day. Let's move to another common UI element, tooltips. we have hidden tooltip in closed state for SmartAnimate to work. Unlike checkboxes, we have text layer in different state which is not default. To make text overrides, go to its instance and choose open variant. Type whatever you want in the tooltip. As you can see, we have overridden the text. Change it back to closed state. Go back. Add interaction using trigger as while pressing. Preview prototype. Looks neat. Moving on, we will check drag interactions on interactive components. We have slider and swipe gestures here. Observe the layer structure in slider and control. We will see how it animates in a minute. Select the knob and connect it to the next variant. Default trigger is on click. Change it to on drag for realistic feel. Preview prototype. It's looking just like a real app. The next one is swipe gesture. You can see that the gesture part is hidden behind the card. This is needed for nice reveal effect. Connect this card frame to the next variant and vice versa. Change trigger to on drag. I have added multiple card instances on the interface. I also changed the text layers for real feel. Preview the prototype. See how easy it is to do this now. And the best part is, all the overrides are updated in real time. The next example is counter. Remember the counter tutorial? I had to duplicate multiple frames to make it work. Well, not anymore. Now we just have to connect components correctly. Verify the number positions and that's it. Add the instance on the frame to test it out. Absolutely fantastic. Now it's time for some time trigger examples. We can now create loading animations in just minutes. Here are two circles with different sizes and slightly different color. Observe that the frame sizes for both of them is exactly the same. Interactive components currently work well with the same size components. Connect both of them with time trigger. Delay of 1 millisecond. I'm setting animation duration to 1000 milliseconds. It will give nice breathing effect. drag an instance on the frame to preview. Reload prototype. This breathing effect is so satisfying to watch. Let's try adding two of them. Reload. Looks kind of cool, isn't it? Let me try one more variation here. I'm changing the state of one instance. Figma will start animating from this state. Bring them closer and reload prototype. It's wonderful. We no longer need to add choppy GIFs for such interactions. The next one is linear loading indicator. I have red background frame and a rectangle with a gradient. I have placed rectangles at two extreme ends. The smart animate will animate the positions. Connect first frame with the time trigger and duration as 1000 milliseconds. You can connect second frame to the first one with smart animate if you want back and forth movement. I want unidirectional animation, hence I am selecting instant as animation, which will start animation again from the left. Drag the instance on canvas and see it in action. As this component wasn't responsive, it needs few tweaks. For now, I'll match its size to iPhone 10 screen size. Change size and position of rectangles once again. Reload prototype. Perfect. You can add multiple such animations on a single page. The final animation for mobile is loading state. I'm assuming that now you already know how to do this. Let me just add interactions. By the way, we saw all components one by one. Now let's try everything together before we wrap up mobile interactions. Wonderful. Which one of this is your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. Wait, tutorial is not over yet. We have web interactions too. Let's start with navigation links. We have inactive tab and active tab variants along with their hover states. We just need to connect them using trigger as while hovering, duration as 100 milliseconds. Also, for buttons, we have default, hover, and pray state. Connect default to hover with while hovering as trigger. Connect the hover state with pray state with while pressing as trigger. All these navigation links are inside auto layout frame. Currently, interactive components are not working when they are inside another component. Preview prototype. This navigation links are looking good. Let's add card hover effect. Just like circular loader, the frame sizes for both the cards is exactly the same. Just the card background size is changed. We need to do this for card growing effect using Smart Animate. Test the interactions. All of these interactions are taking us much closer to realistic prototype. The final element on the screen is image slider. Here's a component with rectangle for background and text layer for country name. You can connect this with time trigger as after delay, the delay of 2000 milliseconds, that is 2 seconds, animation as smart animate. Now images will change after 2 seconds. We can tweak Smart Animate to make it smoother. Now let's check all web interactions together. The image slider is running while you can interact with rest of the components on the screen. This is fantastic. I'm sure you understand how important this update is. This is going to make you a better designer. Before we wrap up, I want to reiterate that this is a beta update. Some things might change or behave differently in coming weeks. So if you need to share these designs with non-beta users or your clients, you can turn off interactive components in prototype mode. Feel free to post bugs and suggestions in Figma's official support forum. Figma has good track record of listening to our feedback. I hope this was helpful. Thumbs up if you liked it, comment if you loved it, and subscribe to stay notified with upcoming videos. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.